walk around because I know that's when I'm talking in front of people. And if you don't mind, I'd like to take a selfie at the end so they can show my mom and dad that I visited with Nairobi. They might not be you. But yeah, so I come from an innovation and technology hub called Bongo Hive. We're based in Lusaka, Zambia. You can go to the next slide. So we have tech in our DNA. So some people might recognize what this screen looks like with a lot of black and white dots and things like that. This is where I live. This is home for me. And this is, in a sense, where Bongo Hive started. We started with trying to help young people that were coming out of college and university and helping them understand what these letters and numbers mean. So building websites, building applications, and that kind of stuff. And then the next slide. So between that slide and this slide, about 5 years has gone by. So 2011 is when we started. This happened just this weekend, where we did a hackathon for the financial inclusion industry. We're trying to brainstorm with young people, how do we get people who are unbanked to become, basically to have bank accounts, to get banked. So you can imagine between that slide, a lot has happened. I will go into it very, very slowly. I wish we had more time, but we can go to the next slide. So what Bongo Hive does right now is that we help startups. We have three programs that we offer. We call them Discover, Launch, and Thrive. And it basically takes you from the typical person that comes into Bongo Hive now is someone who comes straight off the street and says, I have an idea, help me figure it out. And it's really exciting because you can feel the passion with when they're starting to describe what's happening in their head. Some people like it's like they want to explode. It's like I did not know that there was a place in the world in Zambia, actually in Zambia, but some people think in the world that I could come and just openly talk about what my ideas are. So Discover is a three-week intense bootcamp, and it costs about I guess I'll use US dollars. It costs about $50 to attend for 3 weeks. It's really, really intensive. Basically, you want to crush every expectation you have of your business being successful first. And then we build it back up and say, you know, this is actually what's real. Because running a business is hard. Running a business in Zambia is harder. So we don't want people to leave at Bongo Hive with unnecessary, with wrong expectations. But they do leave excited. And at the end, we end with a pitch night and we give them cake. So if you want to come to one of our programs, you'll have cake at the end. So that's always a hit. But the value of the mind shift that my sisters were describing is invaluable. So that's Discover. And the next slide is Launch. So Launch is what you might call pre-acceleration. So this is for businesses that are running. It takes 3 months for you to go through. It costs about $200 to attend. And we're assuming that businesses are working during the day, so we meet them during the evening. So we give them business incubation support. We give them business support, we give them legal advice, we give them financial advice as well. And there's a round table type of setting where you're bouncing ideas off of each other. So there's that peer-to-peer learning as well. So in Wanjuhi's case, hopefully if she had come to Bongo Hive, she wouldn't have had to split with her founder, that we would have been able to advise her along the path then. And then the next slide is something that we're working on. This is not a broken slide, it's a black box. I like to think of Thrive, the next level that we have, as a black box. So the black box is we put in a business that we think we can scale. We put it into the Thrive program. It takes about a year and a half. We're still putting the nuts and bolts onto this thing. But the idea is that it's almost like we're putting a jetpack onto your business and then it will scale. That's what we want to be able to do with Thrive. Details coming soon. But if you're interested, you can get more on the website. So, we like to think of ourselves as Bongo Hive as playing in this world that we call the ecosystem. We're finding that in Africa right now, Zambia in particular, that when someone enters into the business space, they want to do everything. What we want to do, if you go to the next slide, is we want to be able to help people focus on what they're good at and help them work better with other people that are good at what they're doing. So you don't have to do everything, but you have to do what you do very well. So what are we learning? this idea. I'm not sure if anyone of you has watched Walsh. This was a cartoon that I used to like watching when I was very young. But the idea is that Voltron was a robot. It was made out of these five lions. The five lions come together and they make this bigger robot. So the idea here is that individually, the lions were awesome. And then you put them together and you make this thing that's really, really, really awesome. So that's what we want to be able to do with our children. And this is for the sake of Jesse. So we collaborated at a forum in Osaka over the last, I think it was the last 3 years, I think it was 2013, 14, 15, where we were, because of this idea of working in an ecosystem, we were able to help with the establishment of this forum, which now one of the universities in Zambia has the first ever digital technology diploma. And in a very, very small part, we think Bongo had helped to make that. So again, thank you for having me. So what are we learning from Bongo? We feel, so what are we learning? What have we learned over the last year? So in between those two slides, there's been a drastic shift from focusing on tech to focusing on small businesses. And we feel that happened because we started to listen to the people that were coming into the space. They were demanding things and were observing things out of them that we were not prepared for to begin with. But as we started to listen, we realized, no, this is something that could actually help them. So we started to lean in towards where we felt they needed help. And that's what we ended up coming with. That's why we evolved in such a way. We decided to stay open. So if it was left up to me, and we have three co-founders in addition to myself, I'm one of them, and three others. If it was left up to me, we would have been a bunch of guys in a dark room in front of laptops. But we decided to listen to what was happening in the ecosystem. We started to interact with more women. We started to encourage women entrepreneurship. We started to feel that it was more than just us sticking to the train tracks, as it were. That it was something bigger. Collaboration, again, Voltron. For me, this cannot be overemphasized. You can be a solo violinist, and that's not particularly interesting. You put all these pieces of these instrumentalists together, and you have an orchestra. And I think that is a beautiful thing. Also, it's okay for you to fail. It's okay for you to not succeed, and then learn from it, as has been described here. And good things can come out of that. So that's a little bit about Bongo Hive. If you have any more questions, I'm happy to take them. But that's a little bit of